You have some critics who have pointed out that DepEd has no funds for SPED, which is atrocious for many parents, frankly, with kids with special needs. I mean, like you, I am one mother as well, so we know how expensive it is and how important and specialized SPED is. And you have critics now upset that the DepEd is defending its 150 million pesos confidential fund. No less than the Vice President, Sara Duterte, her defense was, it's crucial for security and surveillance. Kailangan po ba talaga ng DepEd ng 150 million na confidential funds for security at surveillance? Kailangan ba yun, Senator?
I was intently listening to the explanation given by the Vice President, no, to understand why it is their belief that they need these funds. The examples that she cited included surveillance and protection of learners that could be abused. I want to understand this further because given that they do have under their care, no, millions and millions of children, do they actually handle, kumbaga sa yung mga safe house, no? Kasi yun yung ginagamit na funds for confidential funds are used for circumstances like that, right? Yung mga is a safe house mo yung bata. So I need to understand this better if ganun ba ang magiging role nila. But in any case, the Vice President Secretary of DepEd said that she leaves it to the better judgment of Congress. So yeah. I do intend to have this executive this session with my colleagues to find out what are their thoughts on it. Kasi kung sasabihin naman yung purpose, maganda naman yung purpose, no? Na yung to protect the learners. I understand. I'm just trying to get a better grasp on whether they handle these actual protective steps such that they have to handle this kind of funding. And does it have to be that much? That's my job. Yeah. And I will discuss
good
that
points.
With my colleague.
And ang tanong ko, Senator, in your history that you've been handling the budget of the DepEd, nagkaroon ba ever ng confidential funds? Just factually, ang DepEd.
Yeah, sa akin, wala pa akong na-handle na ganun. Mm-hmm. So that's why it's new to me. And I try, dear, you know, I tell people, you can see naman, Karen, I'm very open to say hindi ako expert dyan. Yeah. Aaraling ko yan. So I want to find out paano ba nagagamit yung funds na yan, and will they be the one to administer it, and how will they use it, and kailangan ba ng ganung kalaki? Kasi kung maliit lang yon, I think wala na tayong pinag-usapan, di ba? Like kunyari remember, Karen, most abuses happen sadly in the homes, homes. Yeah. So what if the teachers are very proactive about this, na alam nilang may abuse na kailangan itago? Baka naman may ganun talaga. I want to understand. It's my job to understand.
Mm-mm. Okay, so very quickly, because ang dami, no, we have a lot of issues with education alone.
Sure.
But you have a classroom backlog. In one interview, the Vice President also said that if given 100 billion pesos more, she'll be able to fix education in 6 years. That was actually a statement. I don't know if it was in the hearing or with the media. So that would mean instead of a budget of 700 billion, it would hit roughly 800 billion. Are you seeing this as even a possibility? Was this explained?
I think that statement was made in the House. It was not made in the Senate.
Yeah.
Hindi na naulit yun. Ano? Wala naman siyang request na ganun. Usually kasi those are responses to a certain
question.
So this was not taken up in the Senate. What I can show you, Karen, and I think you have it on your slide
now. It's here now.
I did my own computations. Kasi if you look at that last number, yung 5.92, yan kasi yung budget na binigay ngayon. Kaya sinabi
592,
ko...
592, okay.
Kung yan ang budget, de ang magagawa natin is 2,300 classroom and it will take 38 years, okay? And then I used the same because one classroom is 2.5 million, so if we want to finish it in 10 years, That's a 22 billion budget per year. And if we want it in 6 years during this administration, that's 37 billion pesos per year. Now, the reason I need to show you how many classrooms and how many per year is because we have to look at the capacity of the WH to use these funds. Kasi ang naging problem, and I already explained how it works, right? We put in funds in an agency, malalaman na lang namin mid-year and then officially during the budget, sasabihin, kalahati lang nagamit, one-fourth ang nagamit. Hindi na ibibigyan ng ganung pondo yun kasi hindi nagagamit, di ba? So during the DepEd hearing, because Vice President Secretary Saras, she has some USECs that are have been there with her for a long time and others that are new. I told them the process that I went through with the previous DepEd and DPWH kasi nagtuturoan sila dati kung bakit hindi nila malabas yung classrooms. So in-explain ko yung ginawa ko, nag-mediate ako kasi ang site identification happens sa DepEd and the local government. And then DPWH comes to build. But there's a bit of a hitch now because we have the Mandanas ruling, which will give more funding to LGUs. So the current stand of DBM is that pati education, pati pagbibuild ng classroom sa kanila na. DepEd would like to handle it, and I see the reason why they want to handle it because they want to ensure na mabuild yun. Mm-mm. Kinakabahan sila na pag iniwan lang yan sa mga LGU, baka hindi mabigyan ng priority.
It's a good point.
They want it handled. And I've seen this happen, no? I'm a big proponent of early childhood education, and we have what we call the NCDCs, the National parang Training Centers, and na-delay eh. Hindi nagamit yung pondo dahil hindi naman ginawa ng LGU. So,
quick lang to, Senator, no? So, sa ilalim ng DepEd budget, just quickly, may nakalaan ba specifically for classrooms? Magkano yun ngayon, ma'am?
Meron. Ang budget for new classrooms is 5.92 billion. But please note that there's also a separate quick response fund, another issue yon, kasi yon 2 billion yon for the repairs of classroom na binagyo, no? That's that fund. Mm-hmm. And according to DepEd, that's why the term that they'll always be in a quicksand situation came about, because the average amount that is spent, the average amount of damage is about 5 to 6 billion per year. So kung yung quick relief fund mo is just 2 billion. You're just playing catch up. You'll never catch up. So yun ang isa pang request nila, that they can have a bigger quick response fund.
Okay.